الحمد لله نحمده ونشكره ونستعين به جل وعلا ونستهديه ونستغفره ونعوذ به سبحانه وتعالى من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فهو المهتد ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا. عباد الله، أنصحكم ونفسي الآثمة بتقوى الله، وأحثكم وإياها على طاعته، وأحذركم وإياها وبال مخالفته جل وعلا ومعصيته. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، ولا شيء مثله، ولا شيء قبله، ولا شيء يعجزه، ولا إله غيره، قديم بلا ابتداء، دائم بلا انتهاء، لا يفنى ولا يبيد، ولا يكون إلا ما يريد، لا تبلغه الأوهام ولا تدركه الأفهام، ولا يشبه الأنام، حي لا يموت، قيوم لا ينام. وأشهد أن سيدنا وحبيبنا وطبيبنا وعظيمنا وشفيعنا وقرة أعيننا ونور أبصارنا وبصائرنا محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وسلم عبد الله ورسوله وصفيه من خلقه وخليله، أرسله بالهدى ودين الحق ليظهره على الدين كله ولو كره الكافرون. صل اللهم وسلم وبارك وجدد وضاعف وعظم ومجد على هذا النبي الأمين وعلى آله الطيبين الطاهرين، وارض اللهم عن صحابة رسول الله المخلصين المحسنين الكرام المتقين، ولا سيما الخلفاء الراشدون والأئمة المهديون، أولهم بالتصديق سيدنا ومولانا أبي بكر الصديق، ثم الملهم للصواب سيدنا مولانا عمر بن الخطاب، ثم جامع القرآن سيدنا مولانا عثمان بن عفان، ثم سيف الله الغالب سيدنا مولانا علي بن أبي طالب. وارض اللهم عن سائر السابقين الأولين من الأنصار والمهاجرين والذين اتبعوهم بإحسان وتمسكوا بالثقلين إلى يوم الدين. أما بعد، we are still with the people of Al-Kahf, Al-Kahf. And as you know, we left them last Friday when they entered the cave and the people came after them, the king, the people of the king. We said that the king Dukyanos was after them with his soldiers. They found them. Remember the first ayah we mentioned, أَمْ حَسِبْتَ أَنَّ أَصْحَابَ الْكَهْفِ وَالرَّقِيمِ كانوا من آياتنا عجبا. Do you think, and we mentioned, I don't want to go into explanation what we said last Jum'ah, but I want to say about الرقيم. أهل الكهف, we know who they are. الرقيم means the tablet. What happened is, when the people of the king, the Dukyanos, came to the cave, they saw them sleeping. Because the day before they were, like we said, they were making dua and all these things. They slept. The people of the king, what did they say? They killed themselves. This is their own grave. They dig their own grave. What do? We put something, big rock, so they cannot come in or out. No food can go in, and they cannot come out to get food, so they will die out of hunger. Why? What's their crime? What is the thing that they went wrong? What is the biggest thing they committed? لا إله إلا الله. Because sometimes, at some times bad in the old days, لا إله إلا الله was a crime. And there will be a time when لا إله إلا الله also was a crime to some people. And Nabi صلى الله عليه وسلم said, في الحديث, بدأ الدين غريبا وسيعود كما جاء. الدين started as strange to people. What do you mean you're talking about la ilaha illallah? What is that? What do you mean tawheed? And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam sat in Mecca 13 years, not 13 days, not 13 hours, not 13 weeks, not 13 months, 13 years. What is he teaching people? As-salah wa-siyam? No, at-tawheed. The meaning of la ilaha illallah. 13 years. Now you give people 1 year, la ilaha illallah, they say, can we move something else?
I don't know.
And the people of Quraysh used to say, what is this tawheed? This is strange. We don't like it. People don't like something strange. They always want to be to something that's familiar without moving their heads. Why? Because blind imitation. This is how our fathers used to be, and this is how my city used to be, and this is how my teachers used to be, and therefore I'm not allowed to move my mind. I don't. That's it. Huh? What's the difference then between someone like this and other than humans? I'm not going to say the word. What's the difference? Like, actually, everything else moves their mind. Even ants move their minds, and bees have their minds. But some people don't have minds, subhanAllah. So la ilaha illallah was a crime before. And the Prophet ﷺ said, there will be a time when the deen will be strange. You still see how it is still appearing. You talk about the Quran and the authentic sunnah. To some people, this is very strange. What do you mean, authentic sunnah? Let's start doing, let's start subdividing, let's do all these things. Strange. This is what the Prophet ﷺ said. There will be a time when people will be punished for saying La ilaha illallah. Okay. So they put this rock, and among the people of the king, it appears to me from the ayahs, maybe when you go today, please go tonight and research the ayahs of Surah Al-Kahf, at least the first 30 ayahs. Go through the motion of the ayah and see what the ayahs try to tell you. It appears to me that some of the people that were with the king, the Khyanas, the people of Kufar, who were persecuting who? True Christians. Those who actually truly believe in the message of Jesus Christ, or Isa alayhi salam, because that was the people of the city like we said last time. They were persecuted for what? Because Isa alayhi salam, Jesus alayhi salam came with what? The message of Tawheed. Believing in Allah, in La ilaha illallah. So anyone who followed Isa alayhi salam was persecuted for believing in La ilaha illallah. And therefore, it appears that some of the people of the king, even though that king, the Qiyanus, was kafir, and the people with him were kuffar, but it appears that some people of the king had their hearts with the believers, subhanAllah, with the followers of Isa alayhi salam, of Jesus alayhi salam. And they said, in order for us to make them as a lesson, so everybody can learn from them, we will write on a little tablet, a lawh, raqeem, we will write their names, the people of the cave, and that they died because they did not follow the king's religion, which is not Christianity, or which is not the deen of Isa alayhi salam. Huh? So they can make them what? A lesson to those who follow, subhanAllah. They want to make lessons, and Allah want to make lessons. They want them to die, and Allah wants the people of the Kahf to live. And therefore, what happens is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants. Abdi, Hadith Qudsi is famous. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Hadith Qudsi, Abdi, O my slave, anta turid wa ana urid. You want and I want. Walan yakunu illa ma urid. And nothing will happen except what I want. You have a will. You want something. And Allah wants something. And Allah is telling you, nothing will happen except what I want. فَإِنْ أَطَعْتَنِي فِي مَا أُرِيدْ. If you obey me in what I want, Allah is telling us, أَعْطَيْتُكَ مَا تُرِيدْ. I will give you what you want. Obey Allah in what He wants, He will give you what you want. وَإِنْ لَمْ تُطِعْنِي فِي مَا أُرِيدْ. And if you disobey me in what I want, أَتْعَبْتُكَ فِي مَا تُرِيدْ. I will make you suffer and will give you hardships to try to get what you want. وَلَمْ يَكُونُ إِلَّا مَا أُرِيدْ. And at the end, nothing will happen except what I want. You want your thing? And Allah wants it. He has His ways, subhanAllah. He has His will that is executed. You want something, and He wants something else for you. Obey Him in what He wants, you will get to what you want. You will get to the pleasure and the happiness that you seek. But if you disobey Him, trying to think that happiness in disobeying Allah, you will have hardship. And this is practical, experience it. Disobey Him, you'll have hardships. And at the end, everything that will happen is what? What Allah wants. So this is what happened with these people. So they wrote their names as a lesson for the next generations, that these people died and everything. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, فَضَرَبْنَا عَلَىٰ آذَانِهِمْ فِي الْكَهْفِ سِنِينَ عَدَدًا. ضَرَبْنَا means we've covered. This is another way of the beautiful expression of the Arabic language. We have covered, we have sealed their ears for few years or many years. سِنِينَ عَدَدًا, many years. Why did Allah say covered their ears, gave them sleep and covered their ears? Why sealed their ears? Because when you wake up, how do you wake up usually? You hear things. First thing, you hear something, you wake up. And you tell your mom, I heard something. Not you see, because your eyes are already closed. But your ears are awake. In other words, your ears wake up before your eyes. And therefore Allah Jalla wa'ala sealed their ears first. فَضَرَبْنَا عَلَىٰ آذَانِهِمْ. So you see, Al-Qur'an, scientific. Al-Qur'an is not a book written by somebody. Al-Qur'an is the book of Allah. Therefore, it has to match science. Some people say religion and science don't mix. Or religion and science are contradictory. That's not true. Because if religion contradicts facts, then that's not religion, that's fiction. And Islam is a religion of fact, not fiction. Substance, not suspicion. How can it be faith if it's suspicious? Or if it's shakable? Or if it's not convincing? It's not faith then. It's fairy tales. No, we don't have fairy tales. Fairy tales is not from play. So Allah sealed their ears first, so they don't hear anything. And gave them sleep for many years to come. فَضَرَبْنَا عَلَىٰ آذَانِهِمْ فِكَانِ سِنِينَ عَدَدًا ثُمَّ بَعَثْنَاهُمْ. And then Allah gave them resurrection, woke them up. لِنَعْلَمَ أَيُّ الْحِزْبَيْنِ يَحْصَى لِمَا لَبِثُوا أَمَدًا نَحْنُ نَقُصُّ عَلَيْكَ نَبَأَهُمْ بِالْحَقِّ. Allah gave them then ba'th. Ba'th means resurrection. They die. When you sleep, you die. When you sleep, your soul leaves your body and then it's returned to you. And therefore among the sunnah and dua, when you sleep, because your soul leaves your body, what do you say? Like the Prophet said, you put your head on that pillow at night, and the last thing you should say is La ilaha illallah. Because you don't know if that soul is going to come back to you, or it's going to go, and then when they wake up, next day you wake up and you're not there anymore. And therefore, among the dua al-ma'thur an Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allahumma inni aslamtu nafsi ilayk, wa wajjahtu wajhi ilayk, wa alja'tu dhahri ilayk, la manja wa la manja minka illa ilayk. O Allah, there is no safety and there is no refuge for me except by you. That's when you sleep. Amantu bi nabiyyika alladhi arsalta, I believe in the Prophet you sent, wa kitabika alladhi anzalta, and the book that you have revealed. إن أخذت نفسي, if you take my soul, فاغفر لها وارحمها. You're asking Allah, that's the last words before you close your eyes. If you take my soul, then forgive her and give her mercy. وإن أرسلتها, and if you send it back to me, then فاحفظها بما تحفظ به عبادك الصالحين. Then save my soul like in the way you save the pious slaves among you, of you, the awliya of you. This is how you should say it. These dua, you should know, and you should always say these things. Now, this is the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So you sleep on this iman. And the best thing also, if you add Sayyid al-Istighfar, the master of Istighfar, as narrated by Bukhari, before you sleep. So, the sleep overtook them, and then they resurrected. Allah gave them their soul back. لِنَعْلَمَ أَيُّ الْحِزْبَيْنِ أَحْصَى لِمَا لَبِثُوا أَمَدًا. Which one among the both teams? Because there were many teams. Saying how many years they slept. How many people were there? As you know, the hadith by Ibn Abbas. To the Quraysh came to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And Quraysh, they said, now we're going to get the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. How are we going to get him? They made a meeting. All the chiefs of Kufr of Quraysh, Aymat al-Kufr of Quraysh at that time, Abu Jahl, Abu Lahab, Abu Sufyan at that time, And they said, how do we test Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? Or we prove that he is wrong. No. Not, we don't want to listen to what he says. We want to prove that he is wrong. They went to the people of the book, the Jews and the Christians, because they had knowledge in the book of Musa and in the book of Isa alayhi salam. And they told them, how can we test him? The scholars of Jews and the scholars of Christians at that time, they told them, ask him about the people of Kaf and Kaf. If he knows, then he knows. And ask him about the soul, Ar-Ruh. So the people of Quraysh, they went to the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam and they asked him, how many people, how old these things? And the ayah comes. Therefore, the Quran says, there's no really definitive answer in how many, and the ayah says that. إنهم نحن نقص عليهم عليك نبأهم بالحق إنهم فتية آمنوا بربهم وزدناهم هدى. الله يختلف بالرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم in this ayah. We are giving you this event. We are telling you these events. نقص from قصص. قصص means stories. And I said in the last khutbah that the stories of the Quran or the events, I don't like to say stories, I like to say events. Because stories mean maybe they're fairy tales. But events means things that happened actually. And therefore, we are telling you these events, and the events of the Qur'an al-Kareem are not there for entertainment. And the events of the Qur'an al-Kareem, so we can take the objective of these events, and we can learn and we apply them on our daily lives. نَحْنُ نَقُصُّ عَلَيْكَ نَبَأَهُمْ Their events, their truth, their news, بالحق, it is true. These events are true, and these events happen. Huh? وَنَحْنُ نَقُصُّ عَلَيْكَ إِنَّهُمْ فِتْيَةٌ آمَنُوا بِرَبِّهِمْ وَزِدْنَاهُمْ هُدَىٰ Their truth, the truth about their story is what, O Allah? Allah is telling us, those are youth, fitya, آمَنُوا بِرَبِّهِمْ Those are youth that believed in their Lord, and then Allah increased their iman. Increased. Therefore, if you truly believe in Allah, what will happen? And your iman will be increased. Does iman increase or decrease? Yes, it increases and decreases. Now don't be confused with what Imam Abu Hanifa rahimahullah ta'ala said. Al-Imam Abu Hanifa said, Al-Iman does not increase and decrease, and the ayah says increase and decrease. They are both correct. How is that possible? Because the Iman, is in its essence, and the basic Iman, cannot increase or decrease. You're either mu'min or you're kafir. You either believe in Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, or you don't believe in Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So there is no increase or decrease in that. But how is the increase and decrease? Once you apply what Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told you, then your iman will increase. And if you don't apply what he told you, then your iman will decrease. And the iman of someone can increase till it takes him to Jannah. And the iman of someone can decrease till it takes him to Jannah. وَزِدْنَاهُمْ هُدَىٰ Allah said, those are believers. And we have increased their iman. We have strengthened their iman. وَرَبَطْنَا عَلَىٰ قُلُوبِهِمْ إِذْ قَامُوا فَقَالُوا رَبُّنَا رَبُّ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ لَنْ نَدْعُوَ مِنْ دُونِهِ إِلَهَا لَقَدْ قُلْنَا إِذًا شَطَطًا وَرَبَطْنَا عَلَىٰ قُلُوبِهِمْ قَلْب means heart and soul and mind. رَبَطْنَا رَبَط means tied. رَبَطَ means tied. It means we have strengthened their hearts. إِذْ قَامُوا قَامُوا means they stood up. فَقَالُوا And then they said, رَبُّنَا Our Lord, رَبُّ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ What happened? And Mufassirin, they have two things here. Imam al-Tabari wal-Qurtubi, رحمهم الله تعالى, they say, this is happened by coincidence. Coincidence, Allah is the creator of coincidence, by the way. One of them, the biggest one, he said, how can these people worship idols? How can they worship idols? I cannot worship idols. I believe in the Lord of the worlds. And all of a sudden, another man came and said the same thing to him. So all these youth, they came together and they said the same thing. And then they all stood up and said, رَبُّنَا رَبُّ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ We are no longer afraid. Our Lord is the Lord of heavens and earth. Other Mufassirin say, no, this happened in front of the king, Dikyanos. The king, when he sent his intelligence and spies and knew that these youth were worshipping Allah, the creator, the world, the Lord of the worlds, and they are not worshipping idols, they are following Isa, Jesus alayhi salam, they are not following the idolaters. What did he tell them? He brought them all together in front of him And he said, he brought the idols. He said, you either worship idols altogether, or I will kill you. So then they stood up. فَقَامُوا فَقَالُوا They stood up all together and they said, رَبُّنَا رَبُّ السَّمَوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ Our Lord is the Lord of earth and heaven. We will not worship anything but Him. لَنْ نَدْعُوَ مِنْ دُونِهِ إِلَهًا We will not worship any other thing other than Him. لَقَدْ قُلْنَا إِذًا شَطَطًا If we were to worship anything other than Allah جل وعلا, then we would have been in extreme loss and going to the extreme sides of things, failing to meet the truth, failing to see the truth, the light. لَقَدْ قُلْنَا إِذًا شَطَطًا And then they said, هَؤُلَاءِ قَوْمُنَا اتَّخَذُوا مِنْ دُونِ اللَّهِ آلِهَةً Our people, subhanAllah, the people who are salihin, people who have good hearts, what do they worry? They worry about themselves only being on the right path? No. They worry about everybody else who is on the wrong path to come to the right path. They worry about those people who did not see everything to come to the truth. And that's why, dear brothers and sisters, this is very important because Islam is the deen of mercy. Don't try to keep this mercy to yourself only and try to hide it away from everybody. You have to give this mercy to everybody around you, specifically those who dislike you. Or you think that they dislike you. And those who maybe present hatred against you, or they are biased against you, or they are prejudiced against you. If you are nice to your fellow brothers, then what difference does it make? You're supposed to be nice. They're not doing anything. They're saying, As-salamu alaykum. You don't say anything else back to them. You say, Walaykum as-salam. But you're supposed to be good to those who are not good to you. See? That's where Islam comes. And that's where you see, this is the message of, basically, to all the prophets. From Adam alayhi salam, all the way to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, they all came with this kind of message. Consistent. It has to be consistent. So what did the people of the cave say, Al-Kahf? They said, هَؤُلَاءِ قَوْمُنَا Those are our people. اتَّخَذُوا مِنْ دُونِ اللَّهِ آلِهَةً They are worshipping other than Allah. And the problem is, لَوْلَا يَأْتُونَ عَلَيْهِمْ بِسُلْطَانٍ بَيِّنٍ There is no proof on what they're trying to say. There is no dalil. There is no evidence on their claim. They claim that these idols are helpful. And these idols are gods and there is no claim. What does that mean? Blind imitation. Which many, unfortunately, not to this degree, but to much lesser degrees or various degrees, some, those who are among the Muslim Ummah are suffering nowadays of blind imitation. Scholar such and such said this. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said this, and Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said this. That's what matters. Everybody else, after the scholar, after the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, everybody else is a follower. لَقَدْ كَانَ لَكُمْ فِي رَسُولِ اللَّهِ أُسْوَةٌ حَسَنًا Allah mentions this in the Quran, said, in Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, there was the best of examples. And that is the example that the whole ummah should follow. But nowadays people, what do? Oh, somebody told them something, okay. Then we don't use our minds. We don't verify. We don't investigate. Allah, look at the ayah. فَمَنْ أَظْلَمُ مِمَّنِ افْتَرَى عَلَى اللَّهِ كَذِبًا Who is worse? And who is more unjust? ظَلُوم مِمَّنِ افْتَرَى Those who make things up and they are not true. And this is the whole problem of our ummah nowadays. If we can just try to verify things. We take things from person A to person B. We try to verify the validity of these things. Try to say, is this what you said? And what is the truth? Instead of taking rumors and making things and make buildings out of nothing. And Allah said, فَمَنْ أَظْلَمُ مِمَّنِ افْتَرَى عَلَى اللَّهِ كَذِبًا On their behalf, those the people of the Kahf, what are they saying? They're saying about their own people, how unjust, how much dhulm they committed to themselves. Because they made up things that were not true and they were following people blindly without verification. And that's the job of animals, not human beings. You put something in an animal's neck and you make them follow you. But a human being, Allah gave him brain. So he can think and verify and see where the truth is. Scale, mizan, there has to be scale. فَمَنْ أَظْلَمُ مِمَّنِ اتَّرَى عَلَى اللَّهِ كَذِبًا And then, of course, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the ayahs go in the Quran, وَإِذْ أَعْثَرْنَا عَلَيْهِمْ لِيَعْلَمُوا أَنَّ وَعْدَ اللَّهِ حَقٍ. No, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَكَذَلِكَ بَعَثْنَاهُمْ لِيَتَسَاءَلُوا بَيْنَهُمْ أو عفوا وَكَذَلِكَ بَعَثْنَاهُمْ نعم وَإِذْ يَتَزَلْتُمُوهُمْ وَمَا يَعْبُدُونَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ وَإِذْ يَتَزَلْتُمُوهُمْ وَمَا يَعْبُدُونَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ فَأُوْ إِلَى الْكَهْفِ يَنْشُرْ لَكُمْ رَبُّكُمْ مِنْ رَحْمَتِهِ وَيُهَيِّئْ لَكُمْ مِنْ أَمْرِكُمْ مِرْفَقًا. And then the oldest one among those people of the cave, the older one, he said, you should leave them. وَإِذْ يَعْتَزَلْتُمُوهُمْ They don't believe in Allah. وَمَا يَعْبُدُونَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ You should leave them aside, abandon them and what they worship, and worship only Allah. إِلَّا اللَّهِ وَإِذْ يَعْتَزَلْتُمُوهُمْ وَمَا يَعْبُدُونَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ Then what happens? What do we do then? These people are after us. The entire country is after us, the entire village is after us, the entire city is after us. فَأْوُوا إِلَى الْكَهْفِ Go to the cave. Cave is what? If you've ever seen caves, you look, caves are small. They're not that comfortable. Especially the entrance of the cave usually is very small. Usually inside is bigger, but in the beginning is very small. And sometimes caves are usually small, they're closed environments. And how come? They are saying, فَأْوُوا إِلَى الْكَهْفِ يَنْشُرْ لَكُمْ رَبُّكُمْ رَحْمَةً يَنْشُرْ means what? Spreads. Allah then will spread to you from His mercy. Allah, cave small, but the mercy of Allah makes it big. Makes it comfortable. وَيُهَيِّئْ لَكُمْ مِنْ أَمْرِكُمْ مِرْفَقًا It means that cave will become comfortable for you and will become widespread and will become great. What does that mean? That means if you live They were living in the city in palaces. And they were living in the city with money and power and businesses. But that city was filled with kufr. But now they moved to a little cave. And this cave is filled with iman. That means the cave that is filled with iman is much better than these palaces that are filled with kufr. That means those who have the environment of iman, even if they were in the cave, then they are better than the people who are living in palaces, and they are on kufr. وترى الشمس إذا طلعت تزاور عن كهفهم ذات اليمين وتقرضهم ذات الشمال وهم في فجوة من And then this is another miracle that happened. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran, وَتَرَى الشَّمْسِ And you see the sun, when the sun rises, some of the sun rays will get close to them from the right side. And then when the sun sets, The sun rays will get to them from the left side. Look at that. وَإِذَا وَتَرَى الشَّمْسَ طَلَعَتْ تَزَاوَرُ عَنْ كَهْفِهِمْ وَإِذَا غَرَبَتْ تَقْرِضُهُمْ ذَاتَ الشِّمَالِ وَهُمْ فِي فَجْوَةٍ مِنْهُ And they are in the middle. ذَلِكَ مِنْ آيَاتِ اللَّهِ Why is it from the ayahs of Allah? Because these people are sleeping for 309 years at least. And these 309 years, they need sunlight so they don't die. So what happens is the sun gets to them a little bit in the morning and a little bit at night. That means what else? That means the cave was to the north. Why? Because if the cave, the opening of the cave was to the east where the sun comes, then the sun will only come once a day. Because when the sun sets, they will not get the sun. If the cave was to the west, then the sun will not get there in the morning. But it was right there in the middle, so they get the benefit of the sun in the morning and at night. This is from the ayahs of Allah. To keep them alive. What do they say? Expose yourself to the sun every once in a while, so what? So because the sun is healthy. SubhanAllah. وَالشَّمْسَ وَالْقَمَرِ Everything has something, everything has a role. Okay. ذَلِكَ مِنْ آيَاتِ اللَّهِ And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, مَنْ يَهْدِ اللَّهِ فَهُوَ الْمُهْتَدِ وَمَنْ يُضْلِلْ مَنْ يُضْلِلْ اللَّهَ هَيْ المقصود فيها مَنْ يُضْلِلْ فَلَنْ تَجِدَ لَهُ وَلِيًّا مُرْشِدًا Those who Allah guides, and we mentioned that last time. Those who Allah guides, then no one will misguide. And those whom Allah misguides, then you will not find for them leading teachers. وَلِيِّ مُرْشِدٍ somebody teaches him. And therefore I said, those who are usually misguided have no guided teachers. من يهدي الله فهو المهتد ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا وتحسبهم ايقاظا وهم رقود ونقلبهم ذات اليمين وذات الشمال. Another thing here, the ayah goes on to say, if you look at them, you will think that they're awake. What does that mean, they're awake? It means that their eyes were, some of the mufassirin say, their eyes were half closed. So the sun rays and the wind comes to their eyes. So they look like they're awake. They look like they're just slept, half awake. You know when someone just sleeps, says he's still awake? It looks like they just slept because Allah protected them, kept them as is. وَتَحْسَبُهُمْ أَيْقَاظٍ If you look at them, you will think that they are still alive or they are still awake. وَهُمْ رُقُودٍ Indeed, they are deep asleep. You may be fooled if you think they are alive. وَتَحْسَبُهُمْ أَيْقَاظًا وَهُمْ رُقُودٍ وَكَلْبُهُمْ بَاسِقٌ لِرَاعِيهِ بِالْوَصِيلِ Of course, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَنُقَلِّبُهُمْ ذَاتَ الْيَمِينِ وَذَاتَ الشِّمَالِ First, which means what? We roll them to the right and to the left. Look, another one. We said about the sun. Look at the second thing. وَنُقَلِّبُهُمْ ذَاتَ الْيَمِينِ وَذَاتَ الشِّمَالِ We roll them once to the right and once to the left. These people are asleep in the middle of their sleep. Yet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala rolls them to the right by His will and then rolls them to the left. Why is that? So there's movement. The body moves. The sun is coming to them and they are moving. What does that mean? So they're not dead. So keeping the motion, keeping the blood circulating, keep all these things. Movement. Now if you go on a plane and say try to move, don't try to stay without any movement. Try to move, walk. Why? If it's a long flight. So you don't form clots and then you'll die. Here Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, nobody is moving them. Who's moving them here? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And He's telling us in the Quran, وَنُقَلِّبُهُمْ means we will roll them. Like this, and then to the shimal, and then what happened? وَكَلِّبُهُمْ بَاسِطًا ذِرَاعِيهِ بِالْوَصِيلِ And their dog. Their dog. They have, remember the dog we talked about last time? The dog is still there. Where is the dog? Outside. Huh? They had a dog. And somebody goes says, I want to get a dog because the people up here had a dog. Once you become like the people of the cave, then you can get a dog. So, these people of the cave, they had a dog sitting outside. Why? Barking at anyone that comes close. For protection. وَكَلْبُهُمْ Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَكَلْبُهُمْ And their dog, بَاسِطٌ ذِرَاعِيهِ بِالْوَصِيدِ Putting his arm, you know how dogs sleep? They sleep with their hands like this. And they are awake though, like half awake, so people don't think that this dog is asleep outside in the sand. كُلُّكُمْ بِهَذَا أَسْلَمُ الحمد لله حمدا كثيرا كما أمر وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له إرغاما لمن جحد به وكفر وأشهد أن سيدنا مولانا محمدا صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وسلم خاتم الأنبياء المعتبر صلى الله عليه وسلم وبارك على هذا النبي وعلى آله أهل الفقه والنظر والعلم والأثر وعلى من بآثاره اقتفى واعتبر The dog is outside. What do we look at this? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, المفسرين, the people, the scholars of tafsir, they said, Allah mentioned this dog in the Quran, al-azim. في القرآن الكريم, the name of the dog appeared. وَكَلْبُهُمْ بَأْسَمْ Why? Because he was with the people of truth. Because he liked this dog even, the dog likes, they like people. Because this dog liked the people of haqq, Allah mentioned him in the Quran. And the Quran that will be recited till the end of days. Allahu Akbar, a dog. So what happens when, what do we benefit from this? Then who should we be with always? Who should be around those people of haqq, those people of siddiq? So maybe what will happen to us is because of our companionship to those people, then who will be led? That's why do we say al-Sahaba al-Kiram radiallahu anhum, their status cannot be achieved by others because of their companionship to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And this dog accompanied few people of the cave. And Allah mentioned the dog in the Quran. And the dog will be successful. And Allahu Akbar. وَكَلْبُهُمْ بَاسِقٌ لِرَاعِيهِ بِالْوَصِيلِ Sitting right there, the dog. Therefore, you have to choose who you befriend. Who are your friends? Who do you accompany? Who do you send your kids to accompany? النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم في مخرجه البخاري نبيه الصحيح عن المصطفى صلى الله عليه وآله أنه قال مثل الجليس الصالح والسوء. An example of the good companion and the bad companion. في رواية البخاري الجليس الصالح والسوء وفي رواية مسلم الجليس الصالح وجليس السوء. So you don't get confused. The Sheikh is dropping one word. The example of a good and bad companion is an example of he حامل المسك ونافخ الكير. Like the one who carries misk perfumes. Perfume, not alcoholic perfumes, that is. Because alcoholic perfumes are not permissible to buy nor to trade. Huh? You have these perfumes, they put ethyl alcohol, come up, you cannot buy them. Misk means beautiful perfume, does not contain any alcohol, natural. ونافخ الكير, the one who blows iron and deals with iron all the time. See people who deal with iron all the time. Everything is fire, very hot, furnaces. And the Prophet ﷺ is telling us the example of the good companion, the bad companion is like the one who has perfume, huh? And the one who is sitting in a furnace trying to form some iron. The other one, إِمَّنْ يُحْذِيَ Either the one who has perfume, either will give you some gift. Here's some perfume for you as a gift. Or you will buy from him, or the least, he will affect you by his good smell. And the bad companion is either he will burn your clothes, if you go to his doing iron, either he will burn your clothes, or you will have this bad smell all over you. So you should see who you follow, and who do you love, and who do you sit with. And which one is your companion? And there's the Arabs always said in the old days, tell me who is your friend, I tell you who you are. Tell me who your friend is. As-sahib, sahib. My uncle, rahimahullah ta'ala, used to say, as-sahib, sahib. It means the one who is accompanies you, takes you with him. Takes you with him. Therefore, Shaykh Ahmad al-Qalash, rahimahullah ta'ala, one of my sheikhs, told me, face to face in Hadith from Medina, he said, وَمَذْهَبِي أَلَّا إِلَهَ سِوَاهُ And my madhab, that there's no God but Allah. وَحُبِّي لِأَحْمَدٍ وَعَلِي And I love Ahmed, and Nabi صلى الله عليه وسلم, and Ali Abi Talib رضي الله عنه. فَازَ كَلْبٌ بِصُحْبَةِ أَهْلِ كَهْفٍ A dog got successful because he was with the صحبة, the companionship of أهل كهفٍ. فاز كلب بصحبة أهل كهف فكيف بمن حب أهل النبي A dog was successful because he loved the companionship of who? Of the people of the cave. Then how about those who loved the people of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم? Or the household of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم? Therefore you should be with them who loves them and with those who know them and those who know the people of truth. Another hadith and I will end with this. By Anas ibn Malik, narrated also in the Sahih, Anas ibn Malik said, I came out with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam from his masjid. A man came to us, said, Ya Rasulullah, when is the day of judgment? And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam looked at him. A man asked him, when is the day of judgment? And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told him, what have you prepared for it? ماذا أعددت لها؟ ما أعددت لها؟ What have you prepared for it? And the man said, I didn't expect this. I didn't expect to be asked. We will be asked. What have you prepared for the day of judgment? Then the man stood silent for a minute and he said, Well, Ya Rasulullah, ما عددت لها? I have not prepared for it. كثيرة صيام أو صلاة أو صدقة. I did not prepare for it. Lot of prayers or lot of صدقة or lot of صيام. And I did what I'm supposed to do, the fard. But I did not pray too much, too many things. But there is something. ولكني أحب الله ورسوله. But I love Allah and I love His Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam turned to him and said, "You will be gathered with those who you love. You will be assembled with those who you love. أنت مع من أحببت. Therefore, who should your heart should be filled with the love of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So maybe Allah will assemble you with him. even if you just do the farad, you don't need you slack in some of the sunnah, which you should do the sunnah. But then maybe Allah will take you there and assemble you with Him, sallallahu alayhi wa ala alihi wa sallam. Many things we can benefit from these events, inshallah. Let me say one more thing though. After these people slept and then they woke up, they sent one among them. He said, take some money, this money, and go down to the city and get us some food. They woke up, and when they woke up, they said, how many days did we sleep? One said, maybe a day or so. Huh? And among them, they said, Allahu A'lam, we don't know how many days we slept. And that's why when you don't know for sure, another thing, when you don't know for sure, don't say, I know. Say, I don't know. Allahu A'lam. Don't really give fatwa. This sheikh says this, and you have no idea what the knowledge is, what the fiqh is. Just saying. Don't be like that. Allahu A'lam. Allah knows best. That's what they're teaching us from the people of the cave. Allah knows best what, how long we have stayed. And then they sent him to the city with the money. The money that at that time, the face of that, the Pianos, the first king was there. They went to the city and said, give me some what? Give me some food. I think I should stop here because we are already over time. We will try to continue, inshallah, the next time. Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ala ali Muhammad. Kama sallaita ala Ibrahim wa ala ali Ibrahim. Barik Allahumma ala Muhammad wa ala ali Muhammad. Kama barakta ala Ibrahim wa ala ali Ibrahim. Fil alamin innaka hamidun majid. Allahumma ansur al-Islam wa al-Muslimin. Wa a'li ya maulana kalimat al-haqq wa al-din. Allahumma man arada bil Islam wa al-Muslimin khayra fawfiqhu ilayh. ومن أراد بهم غير ذلك فاجعل دائرة السوي عليه. اللهم رد المسلمين إلى دينك ردا جميلا. آتي أنفسنا تقواها وزكها أنت خير من زكاها. أنت وليها ربنا مولاها. اشف مرضانا وعاف مبتلانا وفك أسرانا وارحم موتانا. اللهم اغفر لنا ولآبائنا ولمشايخنا ولمن له حق علينا ولمن على الخير أعاننا ولمن على الشر أبعدنا ولمن أوصانا بالدعاء. وصلى الله وسلم على محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم.
الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح